Okay, today we will be seeing about a very easy and a very simple topic or a very familiar topic, the electrical quantities or the electronic quantities or the electric quantities. You may know what are the electric quantities: charge, current, voltage, power, and energy. These are the electric quantities. Okay, let us see what are them, and we will end the class today. Charge. All materials are made up of atoms. You all know all materials are made of atoms. Atoms are made up of nucleus, protons, and electrons. Okay. This is a simple figure. You can see the A, B, C, D, E, F, G points. These points are nothing but electrons. Okay. In metal, outermost orbit of atoms consists of free electrons. You know. In a metal, the last orbit in the atom, which consists of free electrons, are loosely bonded electrons, and these free electrons are in a state to move, or it can move from one atom to another. These electrons are free to move from one atom to another. Yeah, I said it. Such electrons are known as free electrons. Okay. The path of free electrons deviates when it collides with nucleus or other free electrons when an electric field is applied with the help of a source. Okay, if the free electrons are present, please wait a minute. Call from the college is there.
National Engineering College, Kovilpatti.
Vanakkam. Namadu kalluriyil irudhi paruva thervu inaiya vazhi moolamaga December 16-ஆம் தேதி முதல் தொடங்கப்பட உள்ளது. இதற்கான தேர்வு கட்டணத்தை 7/12/2020 திங்கட்கிழமைக்குள் கல்லூரி இணையதளத்தில் உள்ள இஆர்சி ஆன்லைன் பேமெண்ட் மூலமாக செலுத்துமாறு கேட்டுக்கொள்கிறோம். நன்றி.
Okay, sorry for the disturbance. Okay, the free electron path, that is the electron which is in the outermost orbit, is free to move. Okay, you know these things. Okay, if a battery source is connected with the metal, then the free electrons can accelerate and move towards any other particle or move towards some other direction. Okay, while doing so, these free electrons will collide with the any other free electrons moving together or with the nucleus. So while colliding, the path of movement get disturbed. So this deviation in path creates the charge. So these free electrons, movement of free electrons, is the charge carriers. So this is the charge. Okay, the free electrons in metal works as a charge carriers. Okay, now you can correctly understood the free electrons are the charge carriers. Okay, so while movement, the charge is carried, that is the electron represents the negativity or the negative sign. So the negative sign is the electron. So while moving from one place to another, the charge, negative charge, is carried by the electron. Then what is mean by drift velocity? The random movement of free electrons get modified when metal piece is connected to a source. We know free electrons will move randomly. So what is drift velocity here? If the metal piece is connected to the battery, then the movement or the velocity of the electron get modified. In the previous case, the random movement of electron is present. Okay, when the battery is connected, the movement of electron gets modified. How it gets modified? The negative charged electrons experience a constant force towards positive terminal of the battery. Okay, in the previous case, the random movement represents the electron is free to move anywhere. Okay, now when the battery is connected, the negative charged electrons, what is doing? It is going to move towards the positive terminal of the battery. It has a constant aim. It is going to move towards the positive terminal of the battery. It is not in random motion. Instead of random movement from A, B, C to D to E and F, okay, you can see the previous case, the atom had moved from A to B, B to C, C2D, okay, you can see in the previous figure. Here it is, the figure is, okay, from A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E, E to F, and F to G. Okay, when the battery is connected, you can see the movement is from A to B dash. When the battery is connected, the free electron path directly from A to B dash, B dash to C dash, C dash to D dash, to E dash and F dash. Okay, so what it represents is, without the random movement, the electrons started to directly move towards the positive terminal of the battery. Here is the positive terminal of the battery, and the electron is present in the A position. Without going to B, it started to go to B dash. Okay, after that is going to C dash. Okay, and it continuously traveled towards the positive terminal of the battery. The main aim is it is going to reach the positive terminal of the battery. So electron drifts towards positive terminal of the battery. The average velocity of charge carriers moving under influence of electric field is called drift velocity. Okay, you can note down or write down in the note, the average velocity of charge carriers moving under influence of electric field is called drift velocity, and it is represented by capital V suffix B. Okay, VD. The magnitude of drift velocity is quite small and is of the order of millimeter per second. Okay, the magnitude of drift velocity is small and its order is millimeter per second. And do you know what is current? Movement of electric charge carriers such as electrons, protons, ions, or holes constitute an electric current in a conducting medium. Here, the movement of free electrons constitute an electric current. Okay, if the electron moves from one end to the other end of a metal piece, then the charge is being carried, so the current is being flown in the metal piece. So, to continuously move the electron from one end to the another end, we need to connect the metal to a power source, which is nothing but a battery or a sine wave or a generator or some other things. Okay, here you can see, you have seen about electrons. Okay, these protons, ions, or holes, what are these things? Anyone having some idea about protons, ions, or holes? These are used in semiconductor devices. Okay, here the electrons represent the negative, that's the outermost orbit where the free electrons are present in the metals, whereas the ions and holes, these are present in semiconductor devices, and these semiconductor devices are made up of silicon and germanium, and these silicon and germanium consist of ions or holes to make the current to flow through them. So the movement of electrons, protons, ions, or holes constitute electric current in a conducting medium as well as the semiconductor medium. Okay, you can see this thing in your laboratory, school lab. What is this? This is the ammeter. Okay, this ammeter is used to measure the flow of current through a circuit. It ranges from 0 to 1000 amperes, or any value. It ranges from, for a basic ammeter that is used in household appliances, will range from 0 to 5 amps. Okay, all your households has a maximum rating of 5 amps, and it may consume dependence on the load. Okay, don't worry about that. We will see in the third unit. Okay. Current density. Current density in a conductor carrying current is the current per unit area of cross section of the conductor. Okay, the current density represents the amount of current has flown through a particular area. If you take an area of 1 cm square and how much amount of electrons has passed this 1 centimeter square area. It is known as the current density. Okay, the current density is given by J. Okay, where J is equal to 1 divided by A, where A is the area. Sorry, it is not 1, it is I. I divided by A, where I is the current and A is the area. Types of electric current. What is this type of current? Here you can see a battery source and a resistance. And this type of current is known as direct current. And this is another type of current. It is known as alternating current. All battery sources, your clock, okay, your laptop, any devices which are operating in pencil battery, everything has a direct current. You can see the current will be constant for all reasons. Okay, the voltage will be constant. At the same time, respective of the load, the current may vary with respect to time. Okay, whereas in the alternating current, you can see the magnitude of voltage varies with respect to time. Okay, for zero time period, the voltage is zero. For say it is one, okay, for 1 millisecond, the voltage is a higher value. Okay, similarly, for if it is 5, the voltage becomes zero. If it is 10, the time period is 10 seconds, then the voltage becomes in negatively high. Okay, when the time period is 30, you can say it is again zero. Okay, the voltage varies with respect to time, then it is known as the alternating current. This is known as the sine wave. Okay, if you connect your fridge or motor, anything in the plug, your house having a plug and a switchboard, if you connect anything in this plug, you will have a sine wave like this. Okay, and the magnitude of sine wave in your house is 230 volt. Okay, whereas in the DC source, in the direct current, if you buy a pencil battery and put it in your clock, the pencil battery voltage is 1.5 volt. Okay, if you connect two batteries like this, then it will be 3 volt. Okay, next we are moving to voltage. Voltage is otherwise known as potential difference, the electric pressure, or electric tension. Okay, voltage has three names: potential difference, electric pressure, or electric tension. Okay, the main thing you need to notice, potential difference, in all books you are referring, they will be saying as potential difference. Voltage is the difference in electric potential between two points. Okay, if you take two points in a circuit and divide the potential values, then when you make a difference in the potential values, then the difference in voltage is said to be as potential difference. It is defined as the work needed per unit of charge to move a test charge between two points. I will explain you. Okay, if you are having a 10 volt battery, okay, then you are going to measure the voltage of the battery using a meter. Okay, you are having a meter. In the meter, you are having two leads. Okay, see, this is the measurement. This is a voltmeter. Okay, you need to connect this one end of the lead to here, and the other end of the lead to this point. Okay, you can now say the voltage is the difference in electric potential between two points. This is the two points, and there is a difference between these two points. Here, this is the positive terminal of the battery, and this one is the negative terminal of the battery. So there will be a difference in potential, because the negative terminal of the battery will be in 0 volt, whereas the positive terminal of the battery will be in 10 volt. So the difference between 10 minus 0 is nothing but 10 volt. So the voltmeter will read 10 volt over here. So the voltage is the difference in electric potential between two points in a circuit. Okay. It is otherwise defined in so many terms. Okay. The next definition is the work needed per unit of charge to move from test charge between two points. Okay. You know, charge is mean for electrons. Okay. Moment of electron is the charge carrier. So charge is electron. Okay. So while the charge is moved from one position to the another position through this resistance, you can see the current will flow through this resistance. To make this current flow, what we need? This 10 volt is needed to pump the electron through this resistance. So the pressure which is used to pump the electron in the free metal parts, that is the last orbit of the metal, is electrons in the metal is free electrons, to move this free electrons from one atom to another and consequently to the resistance and to the battery, we need a power source, and this power source has a pressure to move this electrons. So this pressure is known as the voltage or potential difference or electric pressure or electric tension. Voltage is the pressure from an electric circuit's power source that pushes charged electrons current through a conducting loop, enabling them to do work such as illuminating or light or running a motor, etc. Now you can clearly understand. Okay, the pressure, that is the voltage pressure, which helps us to pushes the charged electron. Okay, the pressure which pushes the electron in a closed loop, which is a closed loop represents a circuit. Okay, if the voltage pressure pushes the electron in a closed loop of conducting circuit, then the circuit must do some work. What the circuit does? It illuminates a light, or it runs a motor, or your monitor works, or your cell phone works. Everything is done through the electric pressure voltage present in the battery. You are charging the battery. Okay, so the voltage of your battery gets increased, and it has an electric pressure to pushes the electrons and make your cell phone work. Okay, the energy required to move charge q coulombs from point A to B is W joules. The voltage V between A to B is given by V is equal to W into Q, where W is the power and Q is the charges moved. Okay, you need no need to worry about the definition. Okay, the thing is, you need to remember some definitions, but the basic concept is the same. Okay, each and every definition shows you a different thing, but the concept is same for voltage. It is the potential pressure which helps us to move the electron. This is the point you need to write in the definition. Okay. Then this definition is the formula. Okay. For formula, we will use this definition. V is equal to W divided by Q. Okay. 1 volt is equal to 1 joules per 1 coulomb. Okay. Unit of voltage is volt, and is represented by symbol V. What is this? This is the voltmeter. You can use this voltmeter to measure the voltage present in your hoses. Okay. The meter rating is from 0 to 500. Okay. You can measure above, from the range of 0 to 500 volt. for our house, the voltage will be as in and around here 230 volt. Okay. Electric quantities. The next one is electric field. When a battery is connected across the two ends of the conductor, an electric field is set up. Okay. The battery is connected between the ends of the conductor, then the battery has a potential difference, that is the voltage, and this voltage will push the electrons so that the electric field will be set up in the circuit. Because of the electric field, the electrons keep flowing in the conductor. Okay, due to this electric field setup, the battery will continuously push the electrons, and the electrons starts to circulating in the circuit. While the circulation is continuous, the electrons will start continuously circulating and keeps on flowing in the circuit. The flow, these electrons constitute electric current. So the flow of electrons is known as current. Electric field E is a vector quantity. It is defined from positive terminal of the source to the negative terminal of the source. You know vector and scalar. Vector has a direction. Okay. So the vector direction is from positive terminal to the negative terminal of the battery source. It is given by E is equal to V by L, where V is the voltage and L is the length of the conductor. Unit of electric field is volts per meter. The next one is power. Electric power is the rate at which work is done. The unit of power is watts, joules per second. The second unit is joules per second. For electrical purposes, we will be using watt. Okay. For mechanical purposes, the mechanical people may use joules per second. Okay. For electrical and electronics, we will be representing power in watts. Power is equal to voltage into current. It's a very simple formula. Substituting V is equal to IR and I is equal to V by R, we can derive into two different formulas for calculating power. Power is equal to I square R. How this formula arises? We are going to substitute I is equal to V by R in this formula. We are going to substitute V is equal to IR in this formula. Instead of V, we are going to substitute IR into I. So it will be giving I square R. The second thing is, we are going to substitute here I is equal to V by R. So V into V divided by R. So we will be getting V square R. So there are three variants. One is P is equal to VI, P is equal to I square R, and P is equal to V square by R. So we are having three formulas to calculate the power. 1 HP is 746 watts. Some may say the motor is 1 HP motor. What is this? 1 HP represents 746 watt. This is the watt meter, okay. You can use this watt meter to measure how much power does the motor consumes or a circuit consumes. The last one is energy. Electrical energy is the energy derived from electric potential energy or kinetic energy. Electric energy is usually sold by the kilowatt hour. Energy is the product of power in kilowatt multiplied by the running time in hours. Okay, the power represents the work done, or how the work is done, in how much power the work is done. Okay, here the energy represents power into time. how much power is used in how much time. Okay, so power is represented in watts, whereas energy is represented in watt hour or kilowatt hour. Okay, you need to have a very clear definition. Power is the rate at which work is done. Okay, how fast the work is done. Okay, it's known as power, the rate at which the work is done. Whereas energy is denoted with respect to power into time, how much time the power is utilized. Okay, it is known as energy. 10 watts power is used for 1 hour, or 1000 watts power is used for 1 hour or 2 hours. Okay, with respect to time, you are denoting how much power you have used, then it is known as energy. 1 unit is equal to 1 kilowatt hour, that will be equivalent to 1000 watt hour. Okay, you may say in EB bills, while billing your electricity, how much unit did you use in your house. You may tell 100 units or 200 units or 300 units, depending on your usage, it may vary. Okay, 1 unit represent 1 kilowatt hour, and 1 kilowatt hour will be equivalent to 1000 watt hour. Here the kilo is represented as 1000. Okay, watt hour, what is power, and how much time you have used the power is represented as hour. We can define electrical energy as the energy generated by the movement of electrons from one point to another with respect to time. Okay, when time is not considered, then it will be represented as power. When the time is considered, then it is represented as energy. Okay, energy which is used to move the electrons from one point to another for a continuous amount of time, for some amount of time, then it is denoted as power. This is the energy meter. These energy meters can be seen in your house, okay, where you can use to bill your electricity. If you have any doubts in today's classes, you may ask. Thank you.